Hello everyone, I'm Alan. Last time, I promised to create a video to show you how I installed WSL2 Docker and eGPU and ran deep learning projects within containers. Now here's the video you've been waiting for. Let's dive into the main content of this episode. BIOS and Windows setup for virtualization and performance. Connect the eGPU and install the driver. Install WSL2 and install Ubuntu. Install CUDA support for WSL2 for Ubuntu. Install Docker desktop. Test and play. Now let's take a look back at the entire installation process. Windows 11 Pro was preloaded and I completed basic settings, along with a Windows update. I recommend completing the Windows update step to avoid unnecessary troubles. I then adjusted settings in BIOS, used performance enhancement mode, modify the VRAM to 2G, activate virtualization. The FAQ of minisforum provides all detail steps. This is how to enable performance mode. This is how to modify RAM. This is how to enable virtualization. After completing the modification, re-enter Windows. And use System Information app to verify the changes. The next step is to connect eGPU and install the graphics card drivers. Before doing this, ensure that your system is connected to the internet and that the download speed is sufficiently fast. The process of connecting the eGPU and recognizing the graphics card went very smoothly. As soon as the eGPU was connected, the system immediately detected the graphics card and automatically began the process of downloading the drivers from the internet and install them. After the download and installation were completed, it immediately displayed as Nvidia GPU RTX 3060. However, the default drivers didn't include CUDA support. Next came the installation of WSL2, which is straightforward in Windows 11 Pro. We have two methods of installation. The first method is to run the following commands in the PowerShell command line to complete the installation of WSL2 and Ubuntu. The second method is the graphical user interface. First, click on the Windows icon and search for Turn Windows Features On or Off to open the Windows Features page. Select Windows Subsystem for Linux. Additionally, I also selected Virtual Machine Platform and Windows Hypervisor Platform because I might need them. Click OK to proceed with the installation. After the installation is complete, restart the system. Once you're back in, open the Microsoft Store application and search for Ubuntu. I chose version 22.4 LTS. Then proceed with the installation. Once the installation is finished, you can either click the open button in the store or launch it through the terminal. The next part of the process was the most confusing and challenging, and there are many installation guides available online, many of which are provided by Nvidia. After carefully reading through them, I selected the most up-to-date and appropriate version for our needs. Despite this, I encountered some issues during the installation process and had to seek solutions through Google. I followed a particular guide that was generally accurate but required some corrections. Now, let me condense all those lengthy explanations into a simplified installation process consisting of just two steps. Step 1. Proceed to install the CUDA support for WSL2. Installing graphics card and CUDA drivers in Ubuntu is not necessary. They don't provide any benefit for running containerized CUDA workloads. Nvidia provides two methods, and I use the first one, using the WSL Ubuntu package. Once this step is done, I recommend rebooting the system, or at least restarting WSL. step 2, install Nvidia Container Toolkit. This is the documentation page for the Nvidia Container Toolkit. Unfortunately, this page contains a lot of misleading information. First, don't be confused by the platform requirements section. Instead, jump directly to the Docker section. Follow the instructions provided there to complete the installation. However, be aware that these instructions contain a few minor errors. I encountered issues when setting up the package repository and GPG key. I was able to resolve these problems by searching for solutions online. The solution involved removing duplicate repository URL. I also faced problems when configuring the Docker daemon to recognize the NVIDIA container runtime. In order to resolve this, I manually created a missing file. It's worth noting that the restart Docker command doesn't work in WSL. I had to restart the entire WSL instance. Even after that, the test command still didn't work. The command I use for testing is below. Once this step is completed, we can install Docker Desktop. I directly installed the latest version 4.22. This process is straightforward, and if you encounter any issues, they can be easily resolved. Now comes the most exciting moment. Let me run a test program. Look, I successfully ran a Docker container application to inspect GPU information. The overall installation process is almost complete. Now I have a few more experiences to share. I use Open Hardware Monitor to monitor CPU and GPU usage, including metrics like temperature, power consumption, frequency, and load. I thought it is very useful. I utilize WLconfig to limit Docker's usage of system resources. NVIDIA GPU activity is handy for detecting external GPUs and monitoring GPU usage. That's all for today. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, leave comments, and like.